Hey guys, in today's video, we're going to be talking about self-confidence and how to improve your self-confidence. Six ways to improve your self-confidence as well as your self-esteem. But before we get started, what I wanted to say is, for now on, I'm just going to get my videos up on YouTube as soon as possible. So there's not going to be as much editing as I've done before, at least not for a while. Because I want to try to make sure that I get the videos up as much as I can and as consistent as I can. Alright, so without further ado, here we go. First of all, how are you guys doing today? I hope you guys are doing well. It's snowing where I'm at. It's cold. If you're out on the roads, make sure you be careful. Okay? So here are six ways, and I'm referring to my notes, so I have them right here, so you're going to see me look down, and I hope that's all right with you. So here are six ways to increase your confidence and your self-esteem, and these are ways you can do it, you can do today, like right now. All right? I don't know if you guys ever noticed, but it seems like some people are just born with a high level of self-confidence and some aren't. I've even noticed that in different situations, people display different types of or levels of self-confidence. Ooh, hold on. Let me straighten out this cord, my microphone cord. Throughout my years, I've found like six different things that I've done to help improve my self-confidence pretty quickly. And here they are. The first thing I've done or figured that would help me is I started complimenting others more often. Simple things like, you know, their shoes, their hairstyle, the color of clothing they have on, how they accomplish a task and stuff like that, right? And the great thing about that is the people you give compliments to, they feel really, really good about it. And in turn, they feel good about you. And that alone, those two things actually will help you boost your confidence and help their confidence be boosted, right? And it also helps you develop interpersonal skills, talking to each other, getting along with someone else in different social settings, okay? So complimenting other people is the first way to help you improve your self-confidence and your self-esteem. The second way to improve your self-confidence is to say no to negativity. And when I say negativity, I mean negative things, news, and even negative people. That includes friends, family, and your coworkers. You might have to find a new place to work or avoid the lunch break or the after work get together. You might have to find new friends. You might have to avoid some family vacation get togethers or holiday get togethers. You might even have to find a new spouse or partner. This will probably suck to you in the beginning, but trust me, it's worth it. Because when you surround yourself with all these negative people, and negative things, what it does is it immediately and almost permanently brings down your self-confidence. So you want to try to avoid negative things and negative people. The third way that you can improve your self-confidence and self-esteem is you should try to exercise and eat better every day. Now, I don't want you to go out and do something drastic to the point to where you're not going to be able to continue it. I want you to take small incremental steps. And when it comes to exercising, it can be something as simple as maybe walking 20 minutes a day, doing 20 push-ups as soon as you get up, doing three sets of burpees as soon as you get up, right? When it comes to eating, something small once again. Instead of drinking that sugary drink, drink water, okay? Instead of eating that donut, eat a piece of fruit. Instead of eating those potato chips, maybe eat a baked potato. But small, easy to accomplish, incremental steps in eating and nutrition is what you need to start doing. This has some awesome effects in terms of boosting your confidence. Number one, you're making small accomplishments that you can be proud of, and you can even brag about on social media. And your body's changing, and as your body changes, you're going to begin to feel even better about the way you look, and how you carry yourself is going to change. You're going to start carrying yourself in a more confident way. All right, so make small changes in eating healthy and exercising. Moving on. The fourth way to improve your self-confidence and your self-esteem today is to stimulate your mind. What I mean by that is every day you should be trying to think creatively and constructively. And you can do this by doing things like Sudoku puzzles, crossword puzzles, painting, sculpture, maybe even cooking a new meal that you've never cooked before. And if you don't like to read, you can listen to audiobooks. And when I mention reading, that could be newspapers, that could be books, And once again, audiobooks. As long as you're learning something new and kind of trying to broaden your horizons in terms of the way you think, or either creating something, that's thinking creatively and constructively, okay? The number, oh yeah, before I move on, I want to emphasize this. As time goes by, you're gonna see a lot of jobs that are repetitive and can be mapped out, replaced by either artificial intelligence or robots. Those who can think creatively will be the ones who will succeed, either in business owners, entrepreneurs, or just providing solutions to problems that people have. So that's another reason why you should start trying to think creatively. Number five, celebrate your achievements, right? Everything you've done up to now is an accomplishment, an achievement that you should be celebrating. Examples are, did you graduate from high school? Did you graduate from college? Did you get married? Did you get the job promotion? Did you succeed in a career change? These are all things that need to be celebrated. An easy way to do this is get a piece of paper and list all of these things. And when you're feeling low, or your self-confidence and self-esteem is low, pull up that piece of paper and read through the things you've already accomplished so you can remind yourself of how awesome you really are. And finally, number six, be of service without expectation, right? Unless you're a sociopath, it's gonna feel really good when you do something to help somebody else out. But don't do it and expect something back. Do it only for the feel-good high you get when you do something good for someone else. The feel-good high is kind of similar to the high you get when someone likes or favors your Facebook comments. And that noise you hear, I'm listening to a scanner. But I'm not going to edit it out. I might pause it. I might go over there and turn it down. Boy, they're talking a lot. Let me go over there real quick and turn it down. I gotta unclip this. All right, I'm back. I hope I'm in focus. Okay. Yeah, so what I was saying was you actually get a release of oxytocin when you get that doing good high. So doing good for other people without expecting anything, and doing good for people without expecting anything back, without expectation, is a sixth way to boost your self-confidence. Now, after watching this video, I hope you realize how awesome you are and you use these six ways to boost your self-confidence today. But one thing I want to let you know is, it's not a one-time shot. You have to continue to do these things every day to gradually increase your self-confidence and self-esteem, which will enable you to go forth and accomplish the things you want to accomplish. Until next time, take care.